Hi guys, my name is Anuj Jindal. Welcome to my channel. Today we are going to talk about certain more MCQs related to government schemes which are very important for the upcoming RBI and SEBI examination. As you all know, this is the time of revision. RBI notification can come out any time, and therefore it becomes very important that we start with a revision with the right set of MCQs. Keeping that in mind, I have decided to come out with daily MCQs so that you can start revising through question answer series. If you have not covered the previous MCQs as well as previous day-wise videos wherein I'm talking about all the important sections, for example, controlling and management and various MCQs related to government schemes, please do go and watch those videos. In today's session, I'm going to pick up some MCQs from government schemes. Let us start with the session. The first question is, in the interim budget 2019-20, the Union Cabinet has approved the proposal for establishment of DASH for conservation, protection and development of cows and their progeny. An important question: if the final budget is not released as per the time period, but the final complete budget is scheduled to be released on 5th July. Therefore, questions coming from interim budget chances are very minimal, but nevertheless, I thought that it's important that we talk about certain important initiatives taken in that interim budget, because they are going to be forwarded further in the upcoming budget. Okay, the question is, in the interim budget the Union Cabinet has approved the proposal for establishment of certain scheme or certain Ayog for conservation, protection and development of cows. The options are Rashtriya Gokul Mission, National Program for Dairy Development, Dairy and Entrepreneurship Development Scheme, Rashtriya Kamdhenu Ayog and National Livestock Mission. If you know the answer, please put them in the comment section below so that I know how much have you done already and what is your level when it comes to revision. The answer to this question is D, Rashtriya Kamdhenu Ayog. It was announced, as I said, in the Union Budget 2019-20. Purpose is for development of cows and their progeny, and it will work in collaboration with Vet Animal Sciences or Agricultural University or departments of organizations of central or state government who are engaged in research for breeding and rearing of cow, organic manure, biogas, etc. Not very important. The question that can be framed, a statement based question, is that Rashtriya Kamdhenu Ayog is going to work along with agricultural universities, animal science departments and various central or state government organizations who are involved in research related to cows and their progeny. Okay, that can be a statement given to you. Let's come to the second question. FAME was originally launched in the year 2015. After its successful completion, FAME 2 has now been launched. What is the purpose behind FAME India Phase 2? For promoting electric mobility in the country, keywords: promotion of tourism, promotion of Indian handicrafts and textiles, promoting FDI in India and promoting Digital India campaign. A very easy question. I want you to tell me the full form of FAME. I have already discussed it in the Kahoot live session that we have, but I want to ask it again. The full form of FAME and the full form of date of launch of FAME 2. The answer to this question is A, for promoting electric mobility in the country. FAME here stands for faster adoption and manufacturing of electric vehicles in India. Faster adoption and manufacturing of electric vehicles. Purpose is promotion of electric mobility through two ways or two methods. Number one is by offering incentives on the purchasing of e-vehicles, and number two, by establishing charging stations for electric vehicles. So they want to establish charging stations so that it becomes practical, and they also want to provide incentives on purchase of e-vehicles. Phase 1 was launched on 1st April 2015 and Phase 2 launched on 1st April 2019. This date is very important. Okay, so these are the important aspects related to FAME 2. Let's come to the third question. In Feb 2019, the Cabinet Committee on Economic Affairs has approved Pradhan Mantri G1 Yojana. Consider the below statements and pick out the wrong statements regarding Pradhan Mantri G1 Yojana. It was launched under MOPNNG, Petroleum and Natural Gas. It is being launched as a tool to create 2G ethanol capacity in the country. Under the scheme, funds would be provided in three phases, phase 1 being launched in 2019. It aims at providing water security to all citizens of the country. So what is the main purpose of Pradhan Mantri Jeevan Yojana? Number one, you should be aware about that. When was it launched? February 2019. And certain other aspects, for example, under which ministry does it lie and all those things. Okay. Launched under Ministry of Petroleum and Natural Gas seems to be right. Launched as a tool to create 2G ethanol capacity in the country, it is also correct. Provided in three phases, it actually is provided in two phases. So third one is incorrect. And it aims at providing water security to all citizens of the country. There is no such thing in Jeevan Yojana. So the incorrect answers are 3 and 4, that is D. Jeevan here stands for Jaiv Indhan Vatavaran Anukul Fasal Av Shesh Nivaran Yojana. This is very important. You need to remember it in whatever way you can. Launched by Ministry of and under Ministry of Petroleum and Natural Gas, as I said, you've already read those things. Funds will be provided in two phases. The range of phases is also important. Phase 1 is 2018-19 to 2022-23, and second phase is 2020-2021 to 2023-24. The purpose is to reduce import dependence by substituting fossil fuels with biofuels, which will also contribute towards Swachh Bharat Mission. Fourth question, under the PM Pravasi Tirath Darshan Yojana, a tour is organized for a group of NRIs and taken to religious places. What is the duration of the tour? A very unimportant question with respect to the way the question has been framed, and these are the kinds of questions that have also been asked in the exam. Important part is the Yojana, Tirath Darshan Yojana, very important, go through it. The options are thrice a year for 25 days, twice a year, once a year for 20 days, once a year for 20 days. It should be 25 here and it fluctuates. Okay. The answer is B, twice a year for 25 days. On 22nd Jan, this was the date when it was launched, Pradhan Mantri Pravasi Tirath Darshan Yojana. So this is very important. It was launched on the date of 15th Pravasi Bharatiya Divas. Under this, NRIs will be taken on a government-sponsored tour of religious places twice a year for 25 days. Okay. The purpose is to promote religious tourism in the country. Let's come to the last question for today. Shreyas, a scheme launched in Feb 2019, is a program basket comprising the initiatives of three central ministries. First of all, tell me the full form of Shreyas, please. If you know that, a very confusing, very, I would say I did not like the full form, but in any case, the government has given it. It was launched in Feb 2019, so provide me with the full form in the comment section below. Pause it right now. Comprising of initiatives of three central ministries, which ministry among the below does not play any role in the implementation of this scheme? Ministry of HRD, Ministry of Skill Development and Entrepreneurship, Ministry of Labour and Employment, Ministry of Youth Development. The answer to this question is Ministry of Youth Development. Labour, Skill and Human Resource Development are a part of Shreyas. What is the full form of Shreyas? Scheme for Higher Education, Youth in Apprenticeship and Skills. Now, it does not make any sense when we look at it from grammatical point of view, but that's how the scheme has been formed. Scheme for Higher Education, Youth in Apprenticeship and Skills. Okay. The purpose is to provide industry apprenticeship opportunities to graduates. It also helps the business or the industry to secure good quality manpower. That is very important. So it is working on both the levels, increasing the demand and providing the supply in the required manner. And three central ministries are going to be working together: Ministry of Human Resource Development, Skill Development, Entrepreneurship, and Ministry of Labour and Employment. Okay. So that is it for today's MCQs for the upcoming examination. Do go through them regularly. I'll be coming out with MCQs as well as topic wise coverage of various important issues on a daily basis through this RBI daily series. Stay tuned and all the best for your examination. Take care.